Und es geht weiter mit Let's Play Fake Grand Order, Cosmos in the Lost Belt, Sin. Ich bin es, eurem Simofix. Und wir kämpfen uns hier weiter durch Zhanyang, die Hauptstadt des Kaiserreiches. Übrigens, da sind noch so viele Regionen. Sieht so riesig aus, dabei haben wir so wenig erkundet. Naja, wir sind hier gerade dabei, jetzt in die richtig lustige Phase dieses Aktes reinzugehen, denn es geht auf das grande Finale zu. Der große, göttliche Herrscher wartet hier in Zhanyang auf uns, hat ja seine ganzen Gefolgsleute hier nun entlassen. Und die Frage ist natürlich, was er nun vorhat, ob er sich uns nun selbst in den Weg stellen oder was da auch immer passiert. Eins ist klar, wir haben beim letzten Mal Qing Lingao bezwungen, was bedeutet, dass eine seiner Gefolgsmänner weg ist. Und nur noch Liu Shuwen erwartet uns im Endeffekt und Hang Xin. Ja, jetzt heißt es aber erstmal, dass wir aufs Ganze gehen. Und zwar werden wir nun sehen, ob unsere gute Jin Kai es wirklich schafft, den großen Kaiser, den unsterblichen Qin Shi Huang hier zu ermorden. Was sie zu Lebzeiten nicht geschafft hat, schafft sie vielleicht nun in dieser alternativen Welt. Es ist Zeit, mit Sektion 15 zu starten. Humanity's Whereabouts. Übrigens, wenn ich mich recht entsinne, hat die Story hier 16 Kapitel, also ha. Und ich sage euch, Leute, die drei schwersten Kämpfe des Spiels kommen auf uns zu. Es wird nice. Well now, it would appear our suspicion about that strange spirit and signal we detected were warranted. We take it you servant creatures are capable of moving about in your spirit forms then. And you sent your bodyguards away anyway. Has the great emperor gone senile in old age? Our scans did not detect any explosives. The closest thing to a weapon you appear to bear is the dagger. Tell us, how exactly do you plan to damage our holy vessel with that? Oh. Jin Kai, man, opfer dich nicht, es bringt nichts. I figured as long as I got close enough, the rest would work itself out. I wouldn't be an assassin if I didn't have at least that much resolve. Assassin? Ah yes, we vaguely recall seeing you somewhere before. Ah, of course, this must be one of those alternate histories. How very strange. What are you saying? You forgot what I looked like up until now? We have been governing this world for 2,263 years. Just how many attempts do you think were made on our life? Even we cannot count all the times we have been threatened for the secret to our immortality alone. Did you truly think that you were our sworn enemy? That you were somehow special among all the other would-be assassins? Well, we will say that when you came along, we were still looking for immortality in all the wrong places. Thinking back on it now, Bill, I believe you may have even done us a favor by inadvertently putting us on the right track. We should consider rewarding you for that. Oh yeah? So what, you're gonna give me a medal or something? Now that you and your companions have made it all the way to Zhanyang, we will honor you with a personal condemnation of your strange history. Wait, you're gonna lecture me? No? Proper human history. What a pretentious name. You wear your arrogance in believing that yours is the only true curse of events on your sleeve. In spite of this arrogance, you behave as if your actions are dictated by morality. Thus, we must convince you beyond all doubt which of our worlds is truly proper, as you would call it. Morality? Huh. So you're now going to tell me that this is the good, just normal, moral world? Where you hold all power, where you don't let even the tiniest seed of knowledge take root, and where you casually slaughter your citizens the instant they inconvenience you? You call that a good moral world? Absolutely. What more glorious purpose could there be for the human race? You don't think of anyone anywhere as human except yourselves. You are quite correct. By concentrating this land's bounty in a single point, we have become the ultimate human. Has any one individual ever ascended to such heights in your so-called proper human history? Behold our great wall encircling the sky. Behold the great harvest produced by the land. Who else could ever boast such greatness? Humans in groups cannot accomplish anything. They are shackled by discord, by conflict, by contradiction. So, there will be no humans, no groups. A Zendrin, a true human, shall have total reign over heaven and earth and unite the species. A Zendrin? Don't make me laugh. You call this plotted mechanical monster of a human body of a human body human?
You believe the only human body is one of flesh and blood, that one's status as a person is contagion on whether they have 2 eyes, 4 limbs, 10 fingers. Utter drivel. The true measure of a human is responsibility. It lies in bearing responsibility for this world, its skies, lands and oceans, and the lives of all who dwell within. Can those of you from proper human history choose which species will go extinct? Can you decide the amount of coal that will pollute your atmosphere? Can you prevent the polar ice caps from melting? Were you ever once successful at controlling your endless desires? We can do all that, precisely, because we are the sole arbiter of this world. Thus we are human, for we bear all responsibility for this world on our shoulders alone. And now you're saying this regime you set up here has made this world complete? You really believe that?
We do.
Huh. Then you're a bigger fool than I thought. Being complete is just another way of saying done. This precious world of yours has no way forward. You're stuck with nowhere to go. Thanks to becoming a servant, I learned all sorts of things I could never have known in my own time. The future of humanity is all about possibility. I and those who know me as heroic spirit have walked many distant worlds. You said to look at a great wall in the sky. I did. All I see is a monumentum to your so-called eternal empire's limitations. You said you built that wall in order to defend against threat from other stars. Talk about preposterous. True, they'd have no way of building something like that in proper humanist of the 21st century. But if they had the same resources at their disposal, you can bet they used them to explore beyond our world, not shut themselves away.
Your argument reeks of sour grapes.
I'll admit we are off to a slower start. Your empire might well have succeeded at hurrying its evolution along quicker than proper human history. But I also bet your world never produced anything quite like this before.
Ein Smartphone. Das ist das Argument, Leute. Und auf diesen Ding kann man Fake Red Order spielen. Das heißt, es ist das Wichtigste im ganzen Universum.
What is this toy?
If you think it's a toy, go ahead and scan it. You love analyzing stuff, right?
What could be so impressive about a simple rectangle?
Oh mein Gott, da kann man Fake Controller spielen.
What the? It's an entire computer and it fits in the palm of your hand. If you shrink down that absurdly large body of yours into a component small enough to fit into the casing, could you even get close to this thing's performance?
Huh. But so what? We commend your efforts in packing so much functionality into such a small device. But its processing power is still barely 1 million of our own.
Did I mention there are 4 billion just like it in proper human history?
What?
That's a personal device. Almost every human in proper human history has one.
Oder zwei, oder drei, oder fünf.
That's absurd. It is the very height of foolishness. You hand out processing power similar to our authority to the general public? Why do something so outrageous? Without anyone imitating their desire, it is only a matter of time until they consume every resource on the planet.
If that's all you think computers are good for, you're using yours all wrong. These things aren't generally used just as computers. Originally they were just communication devices. They were gradually redesigned with computing capability.
Communication?
You hit me. People share their opinions, pool their thoughts and work together to achieve a common goal. This is just one more tool to help make that happen. People have always wanted better ways to communicate. They've never stopped looking for ways to reach mutual understanding and prosperity. That's how the people, no, the humans of proper human history live their lives.
Then, you're saying every one of the people in your world is full of human unto themselves?
You're right about one thing. There's no end of quarrels and disagreements. I'm sure we are a long way off from uniting everyone under shared principles and ideals. Maybe we never will. Maybe humans will drive themselves to extinction or suck the planet dry. Even so, We aren't done yet, and it's because we're still incomplete. That we are always striving to go further than ever before. In our world, people are always moving forward towards something better. They're not just stuck in the dead-end world that thinks it's a utopia.
What you claim to strive for is no more than a pipe dream. You have no assurance you will ever truly attain what you see.
Yeah, that's right. It's a dream. It could easily fade away if we are not carefully. That's why we all hope for the same thing, that humanity can reach new heights no one has ever seen. People who hold that dream become heroic spirits and answer the summons of those who share that dream. That is what servants, the executors of the counterforce, really are. We are a sort of being that you'd never think to see in your eternal regime.
We see. So this better world of yours rests upon nothing more than a roll of dice, as it were reckless, far too reckless. Your balance of fate of the world on the tightrope, one misstep could destroy all. We could never permit this.
Yeah, I bet you wouldn't. That's why we find ourselves at an impasse. One of us has to die, so the other can carry on guiding the Earth.
Is that so? Tell us then, how do you propose to kill us? With the plain ordinary dagger? Everyone of Epang Palace defensive armament is already trained on your person. You will not get one step out of the door before you're simply disintegrated.
You still don't get it, do you? Proper ministry is light years ahead of you in terms of communication and data storage and access. And in our world, with all its conflict and any technology can be used as weapon. Not that I'm proud of that. For example, did you know it's possible to poison a computer just by communication with it?
What? You in a tie?
Yes, you obviously wanted to have a lofty discussion about world wise and philosophy, but I'm really just here to kill you. Even if I had to goad you into scanning this phone, so you'd end up downloading the virus in it.
Remember that's
right. It's been a long 2,200 years, but I'm finally going to finish this.
Well done. Well done indeed.
Hat sie es echt geschafft?
War eine Sekunde, hab ich schon geglaubt.
We command you, Jinke. This time we will be sure to remember your name. You're the only one to make us fear for our life, not once, but twice.
Man, I can't believe this. I promised Maxi I'd make it back safe and everything. I knew I never should have pushed my luck quite so far. Maybe it's just my destiny to always talk. Right at the very end. Jinke!
Was hat er gemacht?
You are wrong there, Jinke. Your heroic spirit's true worth lies in dying with a smile, even as you fail at what you set out to accomplish.
Die wahre Form. Bis jetzt haben wir sie nur mal silhouettenweise gesehen, doch nun kommt das wahre Gesicht auf. So, jetzt wird's richtig nice, Mann. Jetzt wird's richtig nice, Mann. So, Leute, wir kommen jetzt in die Finalen. Drei Kämpfer des Spieles. Und die sind alle knüppelschwer. Oh, Leute, Mann. Ich sag ja, ohne Komplettlösung kannst du dieses Spiel immer spielen. Deswegen hoffentlich schaffen wir das. Aber ich kann es nicht garantieren. Ich darf bei... Also, ne, wir haben noch vier Fights. Der ist jetzt schon... Also, vielleicht nicht so schwer wie der gegen Lan Ling und Zhang Yu, aber kommt schon dicht hin. Danach kommt der zweitschwerste Fight. Und dann kommt der schwerste Fight. Und dann, ja... Scheiß drauf. Es kommen noch fünf. Ach, keine Ahnung, wie viel Fights. So kommen sie mir echt scheißegal. Hau mal drauf, Mann. Jackie, du schaffst es schon. Oh, Leute, Mann. Wird schon schief gehen. Jinke. Aber keiner war so nah dran wie du. Dein Opfer wird nicht vergebens.
Ah, you should. The giant emperor up there is going to just fall down and squish us, right? Fufu.
Now that you mention it, Qin Shi Huang has been surprisingly silent. I expected to have heard something by now.
Was, Jinke? Successful? I certainly hope so.
If she had been, then we should have heard back from here by now. It is unfortunate we had no choice but to let her handle the Epanak Palace on her own.
Sorry, I should here we go about looking for this Fusang tree. I'm quite certain you'll find it in the treasury, but I recommend stopping by the Ministry of Technology first, especially as it's right on your way. But if you'd rather leave that fancy car of yours behind, be my guest. Ah, the Shadow Border.
Well, it's no race car, but we have certainly been through a lot together. I only hope it's still in one piece.
I am not sure it is very possible we find it completely disassembled and its components scattered across the floor.
Hey, this concerns you too, Buster. Remember, we need a border if we're gonna get out of this Lost Belt.
Jacob, du bist damit bauen, einen neuen Lost Belt gehen.
It is still in one piece. Hurry! Fafa!
Ah, now I see. Queen Xiuhang must be something of a perfectionist when it comes to puzzles.
So that's why Queen Xiuhang took it apart and put it all together again perfectly. The Emperor had to be sure of understanding its inner workings. I bet Queen Xiuhang would be great at building models.
Now that we've got the borders back, we can't lose. Ah, this is great. It feels just like coming home again.
It looks like there's a box here marked leftover screws.
That does it! Queen Xiuhang is going so down so hard!
Ich kann immer Screenshot machen. Das ist so geil, Mann! Aus wie sind die Brille, diese Aussage. Ich kann es mir so vorstellen, sie stehen so in die Kiste. Dann wachst du die Brille auf.
Er geht da unter. So was von! Oh man, she's breaking out her glasses.
She must be in business. Unfortunately, time's not on our side right now, so I have to do a full inspection and overhaul later. Now, let's get out of here. As long as the engine still works, we should be good to go.
Huh? So you Chaldeans? That's a surprise. I expected a huge pack of muscular brutes. I know, imagine a brat, a little girl, and a bunch of scrawny weaklings.
Hey! What's with you?
Oh, if it isn't Hang Xin, long time no see. Hang Xin? As in, one of the Han Dynasty, the three greatest heroes.
So in this lost belt he ended up serving the Qin Empire.
Oh, I don't work for the Emperor anymore. In fact, I was just relieved of duty. There's no reason for us to fight.
Did you really think I was going to just stand by and watch while you're rode off to the into the sunset?
Nein, du hilfst uns dabei, Xiuhang zu töten. Also, nur so.
Lord Shengong, that smile.
Indeed. That's the same look Lord Bu used to have back when he were serving under him.
I can practically smell the blood on you. You're freaking creeper.
I just want a rage war. What's it matter if there's now a reason for it? Not to mention I've got a lot of help here and none of them is ready to admit defeat. So come on, warriors of proper human history, let's do this thing. You, us, no restriction, no holding back, just good old war for war's sake. There's nothing more exciting than going up against impossibly strong enemies. I can't wait.
I was unaware Mount Li had generals like this slumbering there as well.
And here Queen Ling Ho only ever fought her to preserve peace.
Lady Ling Yao, I'm sure she was great. I loved that whole pure and innocent thing. That shine wasn't gonna rub off after just being revived two or three times. Me on the other hand, I've been waging war for the Emperor since before that mechanical body I crushed in your Egypt Rome. I never saw the years of peace between. I was always kept on hide for those.
Yeah, I bet you were. You're a freaking psycho. Nothing you'd do in peacetime would cause trouble.
Everlasting peace is just a way of saying there's no more enemies to conquer. So I'm awfully glad you guys showed up. The last time I went back to Mount Li, after I crushed the Aztecs, I didn't think I'd ever get to wake up again. Now let me see what sort of messed up killing machines you guys came up with in your disordered world where our empire never existed.
Oh Leute, Mann, ich muss meine Befehlszauber sparen. Meine Hand brennt zwar eigentlich schon, dass ich sie einsetze, aber ich darf sie bei dem und dem nächsten Kampf nicht einsetzen, Mann. Und ich meine, dieser Fight wäre jetzt eklig. Thank you.
カルナバルの始まりです。ま、従いますけど。では、
うむ、
キャー残酷くれます？ふっ、こっちこっち。逃げて返します。私の触手は残忍ですね。アリさんたちですね。
聖夜を踊り明かしましょう。
残酷に落としてあげる。これが欲望の跡。肥大したエゴの圧力。カーストカッティングクレイター。サンタとのバックアップは初めて。受けて返します。
惨めです。うむ。ま、フィニッシュホールドをプレゼントしちゃいます。泣きすぎですか？人という子供たち、今こそ女神の贈り物です。ユカタンレガーロでナビタ、あなたたちを愛しています。 惨めですね。テンポを上げます。うむ、ま、従いますけど。せーの、はっ、こっちこっち、受けて、ま、 くれます？ こっちこっち。 アリさんたちですね。 以前のようにはいきませんが、笑わせないでくれます？神明凍結展開、これはオークの道、オークの願いを受けた幻想の城、こうせよ。
アリさんたちですね。 残酷に落としてあげる。 これが欲望の跡。 被弾したエゴの圧力。 カーストカッティングクレイター。 ではその通り。それでいいの？ がいますけど。いや！ビビーゲー！あ、いいね、最高です。笑わせないでくれます？いいの。
従いますけど、こっちこっち。お釈迦様は全部お見通しなんだから。